Your secrets, if you really look at yourself, you would be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays, kids more.
Where you at? Oh, you got plans. Don't say that. I'm sipping wine in a robe. I look too good to be alone. My house clean, my pool warm. Just shake. We should be dancing, romancing in the key swing to the west wing of this mansion. But hand those cheeks so tight, I won't bite unless you like it.
Yo, what is poppin'? Before the video starts, I just want to let you all know that I give readings, just like the ones that you see every Monday on my channel. I give On Point Orisha Tarot card readings for singles and also for couples. I also do natal chart consultations. My Everything is Everything reading is by far my bestseller. If you want to check out any of these services, please visit my website at www.bandclaptv.com. And also, when you go to that website and you scroll down, you will see a link to go to my shadow work class. In this time that we're in right now, shadow work is very, very important. Getting to know yourself, your inner child, really, really knowing who you are. All of these things are extremely important. And I have a very, very informative self-paced course. Shout out to Spiritual Ascension University and Melanie the Spirit Doula for allowing me to be able to give you all this very, very priceless course, if I do say so myself. So again, if you want to check these things out, go to my website, www.bandclaptv.com. Alright, on with the video. Yo, what is poppin', YouTube and Patreon fam? It's the top of the week, so you already know what time it is. It's your boy, MrBandClap, at it again with another very special edition of the On Point Orisha Tarot forecast spread for the week of Monday, March the 29th through to April the 4th of 2021. Before I get started with this reading, because I don't really have too much time, I am in Tampa and I start work tomorrow, so I'm trying to record this before my roommate gets to the room. So first off, I just want to thank you all so very much, because without you all's help, I wouldn't even be here right now. You know, I wouldn't even be in Tampa right now. I would still be stuck in Orlando figuring out the situation with my truck. And I want to talk about that situation a little bit, because it was definitely an adventure. All the things that transpired up to that point, where you saw on the video that I dropped on Sunday, and also after the camera was shut off, there was a lot of things that transpired. So I'm just gonna start from the beginning. So on Sunday, remember Sunday's On Point Orisha Tarot for Sunday, you had the Eight of Water, you had the Six of Water reversed, and you also had the, I think it was the Five of Earth reversed. So it was saying that a very transformative event, is going to happen. And if you forget who you are during this event, which is the six of water reversed. That's what that means. You know, forgetting who you are and whose you are, then you're going to have a very, very very skewed outlook when it comes to the reality of life and stuff like that. And that's where the eight of water upright comes in at. So I've said a lot of things. I remember in that video I was talking about reading the signs. In my full moon in Libra video, I was talking about decoding symbols and stuff like that, learning how to maximize those hunches and those urges, those spiritual hunches and spiritual urges that you have, and they come out the blue because you don't know. Spiritually, you may be getting prepared for something that haven't happened yet, and it just haven't manifested yet, or it might be a warning of some sort. So these past few days, I've been slowly starting to notice that it's been taking longer and longer for me to crank up my truck. And I'm thinking in my mind that maybe it's the battery. You know, maybe it's the battery that's going bad. Even though I just got that battery this time last year. So I'm thinking, since I charge my phone up a lot when the car is off and all of that, so I'm thinking maybe it's the battery. So the reason why I've been using my car to charge my phone up and stuff like that a lot is because I had this really, really big battery charger. I've had this battery charger for a few years now, and it cost me about $50, probably about $50, $60. And, you know, it charges your phone up like three or four times before it goes out. It's really, really good. Now, when I did the magic show, shout out to Steven Nelson, the Honest Lies magic show. That was really dope. I did that show back in February, and I left my charger at the place where I did the event at, and I pretty much, you know, chumped it up to, I just lost it and I'm never going to get it back. I called the people at the event place. They said they haven't seen it, so I just gave up on it pretty much. So tell me why this had to been Saturday night. Yeah, Saturday night. Something told me to go back to that place and ask them about their charger. Now, I pretty much already gave up on it at this point. But I said, you know what? Let me, you know, follow this spiritual hunch. And as you can see, I ended up talking to one of the ladies at the bar. And she came out and she had it, you know. So, reflecting back on that situation, because the eight of water reverse is about reflecting, if I would have not listened to that hunch and I would have just kept charging my phone with my car and all of that, what my truck ended up doing on that live video Sunday, that would have happened to me either that Saturday night or that Sunday morning when I tried to crank my car up. So instead, Sunday morning comes and I'm seeing that it's taking awfully, awfully long to crank up my car. So something was like, yo, just go ahead and take the battery in, you know, seeking you get another battery or something like that, because it was on warranty. So that's what I did. I went to Walmart and I ended up getting another battery. And I wasn't even really supposed to get that battery, because it turns out that my warranty really went out last month. But again, when you're walking in spirit, miraculous things happen. So then I put the battery in my car and I cranked it up, and this is what happened.
Moment of truth.
Woo! There we go. So at this point, I'm thinking that my woes are over, and all of a sudden, spiritually, my inner child just wants to look at a whole bunch of videos that'll hype me up spiritually. And something that always hyped me up spiritually ever since I was young was watching band videos, especially Southern University. Shout out to them Jaguars. Shout out to SU. SU, you know. So while everybody else is in this space of fear right now, because the Lil Nas X video is blazing the airwaves and blazing the media and all of that right now, I'm over here looking at band videos, getting super hyped for no reason, or so I think. So nightfall comes, I stop at the gas station and get some gas, and as I'm getting back in the car, that's when I record
this video. All right, so all of my mechanics out here, so I got this issue with my truck. It's having an issue cranking. For all my mechanics out there, what do y'all think this is? So I'm finna crank my car and y'all let me know. What is that? Y'all, did y'all see that? What does that mean?
So now I'm super, super hyped, and I'm getting this really, really big spiritual inkling to go live. I really don't want to go live, but you know, I don't not listen to spirit when spirit wants something, because I know that it's always for a reason. There's always a purpose, even if I don't know it right then. So then I say, you know what? Maybe I can kill two birds with one stone. I can talk about the full moon in Libra and stuff like that. And then maybe I can ask the Soul family what they think is going on with my truck. Because at this point, I'm looking online. I'm seeing a whole bunch of different answers. Everybody's telling me different things. It could be this, it could be that, it could be this. And then, as you all know, this ended up happening.
I'm gonna cut my car off and then I'm gonna crank it up live so y'all can see what I'm talking about. And I want y'all to maybe y'all can tell me what's up. All right, so All right, so I cut it off. So I'm about to turn it. I'm about to see, can I crank it back up? Y'all hear that? It's like a clicking noise. Y'all said it's the starter. Ignition switch. Starter. Message from Obanani. Starter. Damn, now it's not trying to crank up at all. Spark plugs along that line. Okay. I'm gonna see, can I crank it up again? Ooh. It's not cranking up at all this time. Oh. Uh-oh, Houston, we have a problem. my car is literally not cranking up at all. It was on at first, y'all. I was playing music. Now, my battery and my radio, all of that stuff works. Yeah, I know it's not the battery because I literally got a brand new battery today. Yeah. Black 23, I just got a brand new battery today. You know what?
So I thought about it for a second. I did the numbers and everything about the situation, how, you know, this whole Lil Nas X video is putting everybody in fear. You're forgetting who you are, and you're letting this fear overtake you, and it's distracting you from the truth. All of this stuff that Lil Nas X is a Taurus moon and a life path number 5. So I had my own situation with that same particular symbolism with my truck. So I have a Ford Taurus X. So there's the Taurus. X is the 25th. No, I'm sorry. X is the 23rd letter of the alphabet. So there goes your 5. I'm driving in a Taurus 5. And just like how Lil Nas X is an Aries, and he did that video to spark up this fiery controversy that's going on, that's keeping people in fear. In my situation, the starter in my car, which is the mechanism that starts up, that adds that spark, you know, to start up the motor, to get your car cranked up. My starter was the thing that went out in my truck. My starter went out. So anybody else that was in this particular situation, they would be in fear. You know, like, damn, you know, what am I gonna do? I'm stuck out here. I only got tomorrow, I only got Monday to get this whole ordeal taken care of, or I'm about to miss out on so much money in Tampa and all of this stuff. But I had to think about that six of water reverse, you know, knowing who you are, knowing that the reason why my car went out, you know, it went out while I was doing something good. You know, it went out while I was doing something beneficial for the soul family. So one thing that helps me when I'm in a situation like this, I fix it in my mind where I literally can't see no other way for it not to work out. You know, sometimes that's how you have to be. So I end up having to sleep in my truck. I get up the next morning, and just like how spiritually things are supposed to go when you're on your path, the soul family showed up and showed out. And that's why I say I appreciate y'all so much. I checked my Cash App, and I had enough donations at the time to buy the part, you know, buy the starter, but I still didn't have enough money to pay my mechanic to put it on, and I didn't have enough money to pay for a tow truck to get to my mechanic's house. So this is when I started, you know, this is where knowing how to read different symbols and decode different signs. Out of the corner of my eye, you know, on the gate, I see this red bird. I look up what the red bird symbolizes. It's a cardinal, and it's just talking about not getting distracted from your spiritual work. You know, not getting distracted from your spiritual work, knowing who you are, pretty much. So even though I'm still trying to figure this out, you know, it's noon, time is flying by, I still got faith. and I still got hope that everything is going to work out. Then I get this bright idea to go and buy a bottle jack and try to jack my truck up myself and try to hit the bottom of it, where people was telling me that the starter was at, and maybe if I hit it hard enough and crank my car up, you know, maybe it'll start to crank up. Chances are, you know, the result was that didn't happen. But like I always like to say, you can be down, but just because you're down, it doesn't mean that you're out. And when Eshu is alone in the forest, he's never truly alone. So I met this old guy, and his name is Mike, you know, the Archangel Michael. I know that now. And he frequently goes to the McDonald's that I shoot my videos at. So, you know, he knows that I'm a spiritual person. He knows that I do readings and all of that type of stuff. And we've always had this really, really, really cool relationship. Every time I would see him, you know, we would say hi to each other, you know, different, you know, stuff like that. Now, it's never been a situation until now where I had to ask him for something, because I really don't like asking people for stuff. But in my mind, I'm thinking like, yo, if I could just get a jump, maybe that's all I need. So I ended up hitting Mike up, tried to give me a jump. That didn't work. So now he's like, man, I don't know what I can do to help you. Then all of a sudden, he calls this company. I'm not gonna tell the name of the company. He calls this company up, and they come out, look at my truck. It's like, there's nothing we can do, so we're gonna have to call you a tow truck. So I'm like, shit, I can't afford it. Or so I thought. So the tow truck person gets here. As you can see, my truck is getting towed. And at this point, I'm still trying to think positive, because I'm like, yo, I don't know how I'm going to pay for all of this. Long story short, not trying to keep this going too long, due to some loopholes and, you know, just how miraculous things always work out when you're doing what you're supposed to do on this journey. I got a free tow truck ride to my mechanic spot. A free tow truck ride, which was no cost to Mike, and I paid him anyway. You know, I paid him anyway just for helping me out, because that's just the right thing to do. So now I'm over here at my mechanic. Now, my mechanic is a SU, you know, he's a Virgo, he's an SU. Shout out to my Dominicans, shout out to my Puerto Ricans. I think my mechanic is a Dominican, if I'm not mistaken, or he might be Puerto Rican, I'm not sure, I gotta ask him. So it turns out where I thought the starter was at, it wasn't there. You know, it was somewhere totally different. And that's the reason why I'm so glad that I got him as a mechanic, because he's super dope. If anybody in the Orlando, Florida area needs a mechanic, let me know. So as you can see, that's my old starter, and that's how my truck looked as we were going to pick up the new starter, which, since I waited, you know, I didn't go half cocked, and you know, I waited on him, and I was able to get that starter for a way cheaper price than if I would have got it on my own. So long story short, you know, he was able to put the starter on. I was able to pay him for his labor, and now I'm in Tampa.
Right.
here it goes.
So it really was the starter. It really was the starter. There it is. Ooh, there it go, y'all.
You know, it was a crazy adventure, but it showed me a lot. You know, number one, one of the main things that I was reflecting on last week was that, you know, I feel like I put out really good content. And I remember 2019, 2020, I'll put out videos and they would get almost 1,000 views. But then something happened with my channel to where I put out videos and I barely get 200 views. I barely get, 300 views. I barely get 250 views, you know. And for someone who puts a lot into what they do and you want as many people to see it as possible, it can kind of mess with you a little bit. But one thing that this whole situation taught me is that literally, it don't take a lot. It only takes a few loyal supporters to really, really make a difference, you know? And this situation that I went through, even though to some it might be small, you know, this might be something small, but for me, it's always the little things that I look at that really, really teaches me these lessons and stuff like that. So I just really want to, from the bottom of my heart, let you all know that I love y'all, I appreciate y'all, and even though I have a small channel, the Soul Family is huge. The energy that the Soul Family provides, even though it's a small number, is powerful enough to power this whole planet, and more planets beyond this one. So I appreciate y'all, and you know, let's get to this reading. So, as you know, this right here is gonna be the overall. These are by day: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And like I always say, even though these are by day, doesn't mean that you're going to witness these particular things on that particular day. You know, this is just something for you to be cognizant about for this week. So let's see what we got. Now, you know, since I'm pressed for time with this, this is going to be a full spread. But for my patrons, you know that if you would like for me to show you how this particular reading pertains to you and your individual natal chart, shoot me a message on Patreon and I'll be happy to go over that with you. All right. So let's see what we got for this week. All right. So we got the Eight of Earth reversed. That Taurus energy again, that Scorpio. We got Fairies and Sylphs reverse. And we got the Four of Fire reversed. So the way it's looking, this reading is going to be focusing on a certain type of people. This reading right here is specifically for the Soul Fam. You know, this is specifically for the Soul Fam who are on that road less traveled. You know, if you're on a road traveled, but at a slow and safe pace through learning, you will be able to use your potential and enjoy everything that you have attained, you know? And I know sometimes when it comes to us and we're on this road less traveled and stuff like that, when we get a victory like this, you can easily kind of get comfortable a little bit, because we're always, living on the edge. We're always living, a type of lifestyle that is extremely different from what everybody else around you is living. So when you're on this type of path and you get a victory, sometimes it's easy for you to get a little comfortable. And then you got to get that nudge that you need to keep going. Now, some of us, soul family, some of us are facing some of the most trying times right now. You know, that Scorpio energy, you know, that's transformation, that's death, that's transforming, all of those type of things that deals with death and transformation. Even sex, you know, that's what Scorpio is over too. So sometimes when you're too invested in the illusion, sometimes when you're too invested in this illusion and you're on this Eight of Earth path, and I remember, shout out to Angry Man. I remember Angry Man, he made a video on Sunday. Yeah, he made a video on Sunday. No, Monday. He made a live on Monday, and he was talking about, when you're working them 12-hour shifts and stuff like that, when you get to the 10th hour, you know, you start to feel like, man, I'm probably, man, I ain't gonna never get up out of here. And with me doing this type of work, I sure be feeling like that. So this is for me. This is for me too. And sometimes, you know, we can be on this journey and we can literally be at that halfway point, and things really, really start piling on us and all of that, and we're already alone. So it's easy for you to give up at the halfway mark if you're too invested in this illusion, stuff that's not even concerning you. You over here living in fear, you want to stop your journey because of something that you heard in social media, something that you saw on TV, something that you saw on the news, you know? See, this Eight of Earth talks about, do not stop the driving force when feeling sure and calm, because you have enough material to spare. And do not take the Eight of Earth symbol of infinite wisdom as a paradigm without reaching conclusions. As for preserving knowledge, do not make the mistake that these conclusions may not apply to other generations. Without them, there would be no evolution. So in the media right now, you're going to see a lot of complacency. A lot of complacency. There's a lot of evil stuff that's going on, and you got these people in high places. And you know, you got certain people that don't want to, you know, rock the boat. They don't want to stir the pot. You know, they're kind of comfortable with the amount of money that they got. They're kind of comfortable with the success that they got. So they're not trying to, you know, be that outlaw, be that rebel that they normally would have been, you know, if they were still in that point where they had all the money, you know. Or they were still in that point where they were hungry. You know, see, the Eight of Earth upright, you know, that's the person that's grinding because they're hungry. You know, they're hungry. But, you know, once you get complacent and you get a little comfortable, you know, you forget that you're still on this spiritual journey. You still got to go forward. You still got to keep moving forward, you know, and that the things that you're building is not just for you. It's for your future generations. And when we look at what's going on in the media right now with this illusion, you know, we're seeing a lack of empathy for the children, a lack of thinking about the well-being of the children, a lack of thinking about the well-being of the babies. You know, we're not thinking about the babies right now, you know, because you got these people in high places and they don't care because it's not happening to them. You know, they're successful. They got all the stuff that they feel like that they want. So they don't care about the underdog no more. You know, they don't care about the little man no more. You know, you don't want to be this person, because, you know, this is your spirit team telling you with this 4 or 5, you know, the bonanza has not stopped. You know, do not forget that everything has been obtained through effort. Do not reject your soul family demands or corporate requirements, since dispersion and dissension may cause adverse effects. Bear this in mind, you know. So you're on this journey, you get to a certain point, you know, where now the money's starting to come through. Now you're finally getting the recognition and the attention and all of that stuff that you want, you know, that you've always thought you deserved. Then all of a sudden, you know, you stop going hard like you used to. You soften up. You start to slack off. You know, your content, your message isn't as good as it used to be. You know, and you're under this illusion that the things that you've accrued is gonna always be there. That's the worst mind state to be in, because, you know, like this says, you took a lot of effort. It took a lot of effort for you to get to where you are. And they always say it's easier to fall down from the top, but it's not that easy to get back up. And, you know, it's hard to go up, but it's easy to slide down, you know. So definitely keep that in mind this week, because that's the overall. So let's see what Monday has for us. All right, so this is the don't let yourself down, and definitely that's what I was going through yesterday. All right, don't let yourself down. Don't do black magic on yourself, you know. And we have Baba Luaye. So what this is saying is, because this is a person that is very wise, this is a person that is extremely wise, you know, he's very spiritually sound, he's extremely wise, and he has this ability to heal, but he also has the ability to cause disease and stuff like that. And it's not just him doing this in a massive type of way. This is also you doing this to yourself. You got the power to heal yourself, to speak healing upon yourself, or you got the power to condemn yourself. Just think, yesterday, if I was thinking so negatively, if I was thinking negatively about my situation, you know, I'm thinking that, man, I ain't hardly got no subscribers. I ain't hardly got nobody that watch my videos anyway. So, yeah, I said, you know, people can donate, but you know, people probably ain't finna donate. You know, they don't really care. You know, they don't really care like that. You know, what if I was thinking it? What if I was thinking like, man, I'm just gonna be stranded here. You know, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I guess I'm not finna go to Tampa. I guess I'm not finna do this. I guess I'm not finna do that. Me having all these negative thoughts, you know, but me being this person, whatever you put out, it has to come back. It has to come back. So now I'm doing black magic on myself. Now I'm doing black magic on myself, you know, through my words and through my thoughts and stuff like that. And now, since I'm putting those thoughts out into the universe, since I'm saying these things, it's creating feelings. It's creating low vibrational feelings and stuff like that. And that stuff has to manifest. It has to, you know? So if this is you right now, if you feel like that you're, that you may be doing this to yourself or something like that, stick to what you agreed on. Do not let yourself down. Know that you got all of the tools necessary to complete any task or complete any type of problem or any type of thing that you're going through. You got your soul family. You got your ancestors that's here to help you, here to work with you through this. But at the end of the day, you are the magician. You know, I'm talking to my soul fam. You are the magicians, you know? So this don't need to be in reverse when it comes to us. Because when we're talking about this in the media right now, some things that you may see in the media this week, you're going to see a lot of important people doing things, putting their foot in their mouth. Because they coming off as this one thing, but then they're saying these adverse things, and all it's gonna look like is like, yo, like you're just letting yourself down at this point. You know, you're gonna look at this thing in the media, whatever it's gonna be, and you're gonna look at that person like, yo, like you're letting yourself down. You caused this on yourself. This is the if I die and my soul be lost, it's nobody's fault but mine. That's what this entails, you know, in its entirety. If I die and my soul be lost, ain't nobody's fault but mine, you know. So let's see what Tuesday has for us. All right, message from Earth. That's good. Okay, let's see. All right, undies and mermaids. All right, the three of air, the time of desperation is over. That's what I'm bringing to y'all today. Because you stayed emotionally and spiritually balanced. You know? So wherever Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces is in your chart, because you heeded this message, you know, now you're able to tell the world, now you're able to tell the world and show the world about these prosperous things that's going on in your life, like I'm doing to y'all, like I'm doing for y'all today, you know. Three of air. The time of desperation. Thinking that you're an easy prey and all of that. You know, those things are over. And it's time for you to shout it out to the world. You know? This Undies and Mermaids is talking about someone who has a lot of experience in a particular field. And this can also talk about the media. So, you know, due to this message from Earth that happened to me due to my soul family, you know, due to me keeping a level head and not doing dark magic on myself, not letting myself down, now, you know, now this is me, the old man Legba, on top of what I thought was about to be a barren desert, you know, but I gave it a try, tried to plant some things, and as you can see, you know, it's some little flowers, some little, you know, here and there, but let me keep planting seeds, let me keep growing things. This desert, in a few years' time, or, you know, a few generations' time, you know, this desert is going to be a lush oasis, and you're going to have people that's old like him, that's going to be telling the youth about once upon a time, this was once a barren desert, and it took for this certain Legba figure with the serpent wisdom, with the wisdom of a Nazi, to look at this barren land and look at it as this oasis in his mind first. And then he listened to his soul family, you know, he was the magician upright, and he planted some seeds, he watered them, and, you know, it was because of what he did in that little bitty, you know, with those little plants that created this lush oasis that you kids can play in the forest and all of that stuff, you know? And this is you watering. This is you seeing that that plot of land or whatever. And this is you watering that plot of land. You know? See, everybody else is looking at you like this. But remember, this is the soul family that I'm talking to. You know, so everything that we do, until it gets off the ground, people are gonna look at it like this. And they're gonna try to give you this type of mindset too. But every time you don't listen and you keep going, you know, this turns into this, you know, this message from Earth happens, and now everybody in the media, everybody wants to know, you know, how you did it. Everybody wants to know how did you do it? How you did it? How did you do it? You know? So this is very important. This is faith. You know, having faith. Keeping yourself emotionally, spiritually balanced. Remember what I talked about in my full moon in Libra video about that. You know? So that's going to be very important for the soul family at this time. All right. So let's see what Wednesday has for us. Okay. So we got the Seven of Air. We got the Four of Water upright. I mean, reversed. Okay. And we got the Six of Air. This is telling a heck of a story right here. Let's keep going. All right. You overcame your struggles. All right. So, shout out to the Leo moon, the Aries moon, and the Sagittarius moon. If you're a Sagittarius moon, a Leo moon, or Aries moon, you know, shout out to my Daughters of Oshun, my Pumbageras, and my baby Oyas, and my baby Obatalas with the Sagittarius energy. A lot of y'all are going to be telling some success stories about you know, how you was spiritually down, you know, you was going through some things and, you know, you overcame your struggles, you know, you struggled with abandonment issues mentally, you struggled with some losses, you know, but this four water talks about what was dormant or what was sleep or what was thought to be dead has risen from the dead. So Easter is coming up real soon. You know, this is the resurrection, you know. And then the eight of air reversed, that's the phoenix rising from the ashes. So this is resurrection from the dead. And now, since you've resurrected from the dead, now you got to make an exodus. Now you got to make an exodus. Because remember, this is you. Upright. You know? This is the soul family. So, a lot of us, we've came from these beginnings where everything was just spiritually low. A lot of us, we came from a lot of struggling. A lot of us, we came from a lot of struggling and we're victorious, you know, and we want to keep this invigorated, victorious type of mindset. You know, this is Shango being in the house of Oshun where she loves him at, you know. So, people who have this type of mindset, they don't like hearing this. They don't like, because it's almost like once you made up in your mind that things are never going to work out for you, it gets to the point where you start hating on people who started out like this and then they overcame their struggles and they resurrected, you know. So this is you leaving that mindset behind. Leaving this environment behind of people who think like this. You know, this is the ghetto mindset, you know, the survivalist mindset, you know. You're leaving that. You're leaving this mindset. You're leaving these type of people. You're leaving this type of environment right now because you've resurrected from that. So now, you know, quite naturally, it's only right that you got to make an exodus. You know, now you got to make an exodus. You gotta leave. You got to leave from the current situation, the current environment. You got to leave the current environment that you're in and go to a type of environment where everybody's a lot more mentally free. You know, look at these birds. I'm like a bird, I'ma fly away. That used to be my song way, way, way back in the day. That was my joint, you know, because that's how I felt. That's how I felt, you know, when you're a free bird and you're just flying around, you know, you got your wings, so you ain't gotta worry about nothing, you know. When you feel like a environment is scarce like this, you know, you can just do something about it. You know, flap your wings, spread your wings, and fly away. You know? So you're going to see some situations where you're going to see some people spiritually low, struggling, you know, overcome their struggles, and they still trying to be in this environment. They don't want to leave the hood, you know? And some things could have resurrected from them. Some things could have resurrected. They could have resurrected their life, their career, and their being, but they don't want to leave. They don't want to leave. So it's like, you know, again, you are the magician. So if spiritually you're being led to leave a certain environment or to make an exodus, it will behoove you to go ahead and do that. because it's always in your best interest when you're listening to spirit. All right. So now let's see what Wednesday has for us. No, this is Thursday. Let's see what Thursday has for us. All right. So we got the Six of Earth. We got the Two of Water reversed. And we got the Two of Fire reversed. And we got the Message from Water upright. Okay. So we got one thing that's upright and good. Everything else is reversed. So this must be the catalyst for all of this. So this message from water, this talks about someone who has a triumphant victory, maximum pleasure in realizing that you were able to defeat the difficulties, either with or without help of others, material and or energetic factors on any level of interpretation. You have resorted to your integrity as a thinking and rational being and defeated base desires and interests as a way to reach your proposed aim. As a result, your plans came true. All this may be hard at the beginning, but not at all unpleasant, you know? So this is a person who barely got out alive. This person is victorious and they barely got out alive, you know, because yeah, they're victorious, but you know, in the end, it was a battle. It was a battle. You know, you lost a lot of strength in this victory. You lost a lot of strength. You might have got this victory upon cutting a lot of people off and stuff like that. So lack of security measures against outside dangers, you know. Yes, you're victorious, but your defenses are weak. You know, you're victorious, but your actions do not coincide with your feelings or with what is a proper, impossible exchange, you know, impossible exchange. So yeah, you're victorious, but everything may not be on the other side what you thought it was going to be. You know, so it's, yeah, you're victorious, but because of the battle and the casualties and all of that stuff, there's still a rebuilding process now that you got to do. So it's like, yeah, you're victorious. You made the exodus and all of that. So now it's time for you to, it's like you're moving into a new house. So it's like, yeah, you're victorious because it was a struggle. It was a struggle, a battle for you to get the house. So now you got the house. So that was the big thing. But now you gotta get your security system. You gotta get your insurance. You gotta decorate it. You gotta paint it. You got to get somebody to come out to spray it for bugs and all of this other stuff. So you got a lot of housekeeping that you got to do. So now we got this Two of Water reversed. This talks about confusion, tears, sorrow, breakup. So this might be a person that, you know, maybe you were going through a divorce or something and the proceedings went through. So now you're fully divorced. You don't got to worry about that person no more, you know, but it might have, you know, the results of it might have been you had to move out of your place because you might have to move out of your place because that was a part of the prenup that belonged to your wife. If you're a man, if you're a woman, it might have been a situation to where you got this victory, but within you getting this victory, you had to cut a lot of people off that really meant a lot to you. You know, so now you're confused. You know, you got this sorrow, and you know, coming off of a victory, a victory that was really, really hard for you to get, it's easy for, you know, these two of fire things spiritually and these two of water reverse things emotionally, it's easy for this to harden your heart and turn you into a bougie or stubborn miser of a person. Because, I mean, I get it. You know, it was already hard enough for you to get this victory already. You know, it was hard enough for you to get this. So now you're telling me that, yeah, I got all this stuff. Everybody was hating on me because, remember, this is the soul family that we're talking about. You know, nobody said that I was gonna make it. You know, everybody wished death on me and I came out on top. You know, I lost so many people that I thought was on my side. So many doors had to close. It's easy for you to get extremely stubborn to the point where you got other soul family members that's been through your same situation, and they might be down on their luck, and you actually got it to help them, and now you don't want to help them. You know? So now we got this Six of Earth. And this talks about, do not let your stubbornness blind you. Do not covet more than you deserve. Danger of envy, corruption, fraudulent contracts, blackmailing, and extortion. You know? So, again, going back to the media, you know, you might see a person like this turn corrupt. You know? And when you look back at how they rose to the top, you're like, dang, like, that person had a hard life, you know? But they let their two of fire reversed and their two of water reversed harden them spiritually and emotionally, which turned them into a corrupted person, you know? So beware of these type of people, and don't you yourself turn into this type of person, soul family. I know it's hard. When we get that victory, you know, we wanna stunt. You know, we wanna stunt, but you know, you gotta remember who you are. You know, when we get our stuff taken from us, it hurts us a lot worse. So, which means that we have to be a lot more careful, a lot more open with our heart and stuff like that, so we can keep receiving those positive things, you know. All right, so now let's see what Friday has for us. So now we got the Ace of Fire reversed. We got Obatala reversed. Oh, so this is somebody who's not listening to the wisdom from the Most High. And that sounds about right, because this is going to, you know, spiritually lower your energy spiritually. And we have the Legba card reversed. So this is for my baby Legbas. And this is also, so this is for my baby Legbas. I'm gonna do that first, soul family. So for my baby Legbas out there, if you know that your calling is to be a spiritual messenger, be sure that the message that you're putting out to the world is a message. The wisdom is the wisdom that came from the Most High. You know, being a spiritual messenger, you know, these are the messages that you're supposed to be putting out for the soul family. The wisdom that comes from the Most High. That's it. That's all. If not, this is going to be your fate. You know, retrocession in plans, mediocrity, lack of grasp, troublesome relationships, useless efforts, because they will not be taken into account. You are not feeling value. You are hurt. The offense will lower your defenses. You know? So right now, if you're supposed to be a messenger and you're not giving the message of the truth right now, this is almost like Samson losing all his power because his dreads got cut off. You know, that's what this is talking about. And as you can see right now, religion, especially Christianity, has been trending because of all of the things that's going on. You know, all of these false messengers are getting exposed, false preachers, everything. There's so much stuff with religion that's getting exposed right now, you know, because of all the stuff that transpired within these last few weeks, you know. So you're going to start seeing a lot of this, you know, a lot of false messengers, you know, coming out, a lot of false messengers getting exposed because the stuff that they're saying is not lining up with the truth, is not lining up with the Word of God, is not lining up with the Most High and his serpent wisdom, you know. And it's gonna be out on Front Street for everybody to see. The lion, the person who was once roaring lion, you know, that was on fire for Jesus, that was on fire for the truth. That lion is now looking very Ace of Fire reverse-ish, you know. So definitely make sure, soul family, if you're gonna be putting messages out there, being a messenger, make sure your message is in alignment with the Most High, with Obatala, you know, with that serpent wisdom, or else this is going to be your fate, you know. And nobody likes a Ace of Fire. This is the cowardly line, you know. This is the cowardly line from the Wiz. This is the cowardly line. All right. So now we are in the weekend, baby. Let's see what Saturday got for us. So this is the Seven of Water reversed. So somebody is, you know, heeding this message. So now they're going on the right path. You know, they're leaving the illusion behind after a Six of Fire moment happened to them, you know. All right. So this is the Three of Fire. So this is Grand Support. And all right. So this is beautiful. So for all of my all of my Pumbageras out there, if you have this Virgo moon, Virgo sun, you got this female issue energy, you know, and you trying to turn your life around and all of that, you're going to get a lot of grand support, you know, as long as you do not let arrogance dim your achievements. It may turn away those who wish to honor and show you their admiration. Do not rest on your laurels or fall into monotony, laziness, or complete idleness, justifying yourself by your past achievements. Do not become a false idol. So this is for all of my ladies out there. You know, you might have went through a lot of issues in your life, and now you're getting some grand support. You know, you're getting to some money that you've never seen it like this before. You know, stay humble. Stay humble. You know, that's how any man or any person is ever going to believe that you turned a new leaf. If you were once a female issue reversed and you want to show the world that you changed and you're ready to turn your life around and all of that, sometimes the best way that you can prove to someone that you changed is when you get this bag and you get this grand support and you stay humble. And you stay humble. You know? That's really gonna show people, yo, like, you know, she's really the soul family. Like, she's really trying to, you know, she's really trying to go on the right path. You know, she's really trying to go on the right path. So, if this is you, sister, that's listening to this, and you want to know, how can I prevent myself from becoming a false idol? Because we see within these past weeks what has been happening to these false idols, and you don't want that to be your fate, then this Seven of Water talks about look for the solution in the right path and persist. Understand that humanity and humility, understand that humility leads to greatness. See, this isn't something that you were taught back in your, you know, female issue reverse days, you know? All of these songs and, you know, all of this stuff, it teaches you about being stubborn, you know? It teaches you about doing things that's going to make you put black magic on yourself. It's not going to tell you about being humble and how humility leads to greatness, you know? So heed this message. Humility leads to greatness. And only those who have a great spirit reach great goals. Look for the path of faith on a step-by-step escalation. Ask without demanding and give without expecting any compensation. Do not look down with arrogance and do not underestimate the things that you do not have. It may be due to a lack of learning or understanding. You know? So, that's pretty much the best that I could say when it comes to this. That's pretty much, you know, it said it all. You know? And if you heed that message, being this female issue reversed, then you're gonna turn into this, you know. And we love this, you know. This is a beautiful card. This is a beautiful card. Just like the SU card is a really, really dope card, you know. Everything has a positive and negative polarity, you know. So definitely keep that in mind, my sisters out there. And let's see what Sunday has for us. All right. See, this enslaved prisoner goes with this Eight of Earth reversed. Everything is everything. So I love how, you know, the week on Sunday closes out what we was talking about the Monday before. So we got Yemoya. Yemoya. Shout out to Yemoya. And we have the Ten of Fire. But I think Yemoya wants to say something. So Let me pull another card. I think Yimo y'all want to say something. Oh. So now we got Yimo y'all, and we got the baby Oya. But this isn't the baby Oya. This is a Yimo y'all who's been through a lot of storms and stuff like that. You know, she's been through a whole lot of storms. She's been through a whole lot of stuff, and instead of her learning the lesson that, you know, these storms were only in your life to make you better, you know, these storms were only in your life to show you how weak your foundation was, you know, when it's reversed, this means that you didn't take the lesson from these storms. Instead, you've turned into the enslaved prisoner, you know. So my mothers, my Yimoyas out there that's going through this, in order to take yourself out of this prison that you pretty much put yourself in, you put yourself in this prison, because look at this enslaved prisoner. There's no police around. He's not in jail, you know. He can get out anytime he wants to. This is a woman, you know, who's a mother. She might be a wife or something like that. She's been through a lot of stormy times. And it's hard for her to get the lesson out of these stormy times, out of all the storms and issues and hurricanes and all the stuff that's been going on in her life. And the reason why it's hard for her to not see the lesson and the wisdom in it is because she's a victim of defamation, gossip, and felonies. Strengthen yourself. You will need it because your surroundings are exerting pressure on you. You will be a subject to unjustified moral, physical, or spiritual punishment. You are not allowed to be or do. You know, loneliness, execution, suffering. Everything is hard to obtain. So you went through these storms in your life, and instead of you getting the wisdom from it, this is woe is me. You know, sacrificial, difficult, hardship, you know, all of these things. But when Oya is upright, then this is what's really going on in your life. You know, you might think that God hates you. You know, God don't like you. You know, how can God love me? And how can I have a spirit team? How can I have all of these good things and all of these storms is in my life? You know, you're putting yourself into a enslaved prison because you're doing black magic on yourself. You've turned all of your storms into this illusion that nothing is ever gonna go right for you. You know, all of this stuff. You've let yourself down. And you've pretty much developed this scarcity mindset. You know, that's the seven of error. Scarcity mindset. You know, confusion. Closed opportunities. Losing strength. You're not listening to the voice of the Most High. You can't even hear the voice of the Most High. If you're like this, you know. So, if this is what you're going through, if you're a woman out here, and we're going to see this in the media. We've already been seeing it with Derrick Jackson's wife, but there's going to be more women that's going to be put out on display that's going to be defamed, and there's going to be a lot of gossip based around these particular type of women, you know. But for my soul family, if you're going through this, just know that you will have to face the test posed by life or by your karma. Ask your spiritual guides for help, trusting that you will not be abandoned during the hard times, and you will overcome these tests without any difficulty or hardship. Your reward will be an increase in your self-esteem and the acknowledgement of your honesty by others. Very, very important right now. And this is for everybody. This is for all my soul family that's going through these tests. You know, we're already on this road less traveled. So when we go through tests and we go through issues, it's easy for you to feel alone. It's easy for you to feel like nobody cares. You're all out here alone. But take it from me. Even though my situation is very small compared to what other people go through in their life, you know, take it from me. Take the situation that I went through and let it be a motivation to you. I remember, you know, while I was in my truck and I had my spliffy, you know, I had this thought that maybe I should delete that video. You know, the professional me was like, maybe I should delete that video because it was so unprofessional when my car cut off and, you know, all of these different things. But then I had to think about it, you know. What if this whole situation was a testimony that somebody needed to hear in their life? You know, maybe somebody out there is about to give up, feels like all hope is lost, feels like they're stuck and all of this stuff. And then they see my video of how little old me, only 2,000 subscribers, you know, only 200 something views on my videos, all of that, tries to make a live stream about the full moon and my car shuts off. I'm stranded at a Walmart parking lot with only $45 to my name. And, you know, those few soul family members that found it in their heart to send me donations and stuff like that, I was not only able to get the part that I needed and stuff like that, but since I kept a certain type of mind frame due to what I went through and stuff like that, you know, due to different instances in the past where my soul family and my spirit team looked out for me, I was able to achieve an impossible feat. And now I'm in Tampa giving this reading for y'all, and you know, I'm just here to let y'all know, like I always say, that, you know, I ain't shit. I'm just a messenger, but I'm just a regular person, just like y'all. I have issues in my life. I got stuff that I'm going through. I got things that I'm working on. My equipment is very, very limited. You know, I'm striving to be better just like y'all. So I'm leaving that video up because I really feel like somebody, you know, needs to see that in real time, and also see the result of what happens when you don't live in fear and when you're always in a space of love and all of that type of stuff. Because you got so many people out here And when they get on and they make it big and all of that, they start to go into their past and they start deleting tweets, deleting Facebook videos, deleting videos of when they first started because they're ashamed or they don't want people to, you know, to be looking at their past and all of that. But with me, this is what makes me relatable. This is what makes me this is what humanizes me, I feel. And if I can take something in my life to give somebody else a motivation to keep going, to keep moving forward, to keep striving, I'm gonna do that. And if you heed that message for this week's reading, my friends, you will be glad that you did. All right, y'all. So I really, really hope that you enjoyed this very, very motivational story. And I hope that you all enjoyed this reading. More videos coming soon. You know, since I'm going to be working, I don't know how this is going to work out as far as content is concerned. But just know, you know, as you can see with that SU and Pump I Get Out Queen and Slim, it's always worth the wait, isn't it? It's always worth the wait. So I appreciate y'all so much for everything. I got some special things coming up for my patrons. How long has your inner child had a mask on? That's going to be available for YouTube and for Patreon, you know, just showing my thanks and my gratitude. I'll also be doing some discounts on some readings and stuff this week. So I'll be letting you all know of the different things that I'll be doing, just depending on how tired I am from doing this work that I'm gonna be doing for the next couple weeks. So I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. I thank y'all from the bottom of my heart as always. And until next time, peace. What's up, y'all? I hope y'all enjoyed that video. And if you stayed to the end, I appreciate you. Also, if you haven't already, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, I want to redirect you to my Instagram page. I don't promote my Instagram page a lot, but as my subscriber count and things like that rise due to things like shadow banning and stuff like that, I'm hearing that a lot of people aren't getting my notifications when I go live on YouTube and stuff like that. So for all things BandClap TV, my Instagram page and my story are gonna have all of the notifications and things like that when it comes to when I'm going live, when I'm going, you know, when I'm releasing videos, when I'm releasing content. Also on my Instagram page, if you're curious about my reviews for my readings and stuff like that, as you can see on my Instagram, I have a lot of different testimonials and stuff like that. For those who don't know of me as an artist, I also have videos of me performing and stuff like that. I'll be putting out more stuff like that very, very soon. So I'm just trying to get as many people right now to go ahead and follow me on Instagram, that is BandClap TV, and also my Facebook and Snapchat, BandClap TV as well. All right, y'all. I appreciate y'all. And like I always say, no matter what, you got to stay shining.
Next on BandClap TV.